Welcome students, welcome to my next video. My dear students, today in this video you are going to learn how the state of Maharashtra was formed. The topic for the day is nothing but formation of the state of Maharashtra. Before I move on to the topic, it's a sincere request to all my students. Students, if you like the video, please do like it. If you have not subscribed it, please subscribe it. And also share it with all those people, especially those who badly need it, because every school doesn't have a facility of online education. So video is one of the sources, and my intention of making this video is the same, so that the people could reach, I could reach out to the people. For those people the online service is not available. Now, my dear students, let us not further delay with other talks. Let me start with the explanation. Now, mere priya vidyarthiyo, main इस पार्ट में हिंदी में बोलने का प्रयास करूंगा. आज इस पार्ट में हम ये सीखेंगे कि हमारा ये महाराष्ट्र कैसे आया, कैसे बना. ये महाराष्ट्र को लाने के लिए किस किस लोगों का योगदान है वो हम सीखेंगे आज. यस माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फॉरगिव मी ऑल बाय स्पीकिंग हिंदी इन बिटवीन फॉर दोज पीपल हु डजंट अंडरस्टैंड इंग्लिश. आफ्टर इंडिया हैज गेन्ड इंडिपेंडेंस, देयर वाज अ डिमांड ऑफ लार्ज स्केल for the reconstruction of the states on the linguistic basis. हमारे देश को जब स्वतंत्र मिला, स्वतंत्र मिलने के बाद अलग अलग प्रांत हमारे इस भारत में हुआ, अलग अलग प्रांत जो भाषा से आधारित था. उनका कहना था कि हर एक जगह लोग सम्मिलित हो जाए जो एक ही भाषा का हो, एक ही प्रांत का हो. इन महाराष्ट्र ऑल्सो दे डिमांडेड फॉर अ स्टेट ऑफ मराठी स्पीकिंग पीपल दैट लेड टू संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र मूवमेंट फ्रॉम 1946 ऑनवर्ड्स. Through various changing circumstances, the movement progressed finally on 1st May 1960. The state of Maharashtra came to be formed. मेरे प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, हम लोग देखेंगे कि अलग अलग प्रांत के लोग भाषा के आधारित उनको अपना प्रांत बनाना चाहते थे, उनको अपना रीजन बनाना है. वैसे ही महाराष्ट्र कभी हुआ. मराठी बोलने वाले एक साथ मिलकर संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र मूवमेंट लाया और एक मई को हमारा ये महाराष्ट्र बन गया। नाउ विल सी द बैकग्राउंड। नाउ बिफोर द स्टेट केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंट व्हाट हैपेंड, द बैकग्राउंड बिगिंस दैट इन 20th सेंचुरी मेनो स्कॉलर्स स्टार्टेड एक्सप्रेसिंग द थॉट्स of bringing Marathi speaking people together. In 1911, British government had to suspend the partition on this ground. N.C. Kelkar wrote, the entire Marathi speaking population should be under one dominance. In 1915, Lokmanya Tilak demanded the reconstruction of the state based on language. But during that period, the issue of independence of India was more important and more prominent. Hence, this issue remained aside. हाँ मेरे प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, जब 1911 में बंगाल में कुछ भागों में हिंदुओं और कुछ भागों में मुसलमानों को दिया गया, जब वो पार्टीशन के बारे में बोला, वो आइडिया आया एनसी केलकर जी ने, उन्होंने बोला कि पूरे मराठी लोग एक साथ आकर उसका एक प्रांत बने। हमारे लोकमान्य तिलक जी 1915 में उन्होंने भी यही डिमांड किया, उन्होंने यही मांगा ब्रिटिश राज से कि पूरी मराठी बोलने वाले लोग एक साथ मिलकर एक प्रांत बने। लेकिन ये जो मुद्दा जो उठा उस पर ज्यादा बहस कर नहीं पाए, क्योंकि हमारे सामने हमारे आजादी, हमारे देश को आजादी मिलने का मुख्य धारा था। नाउ वी विल सी फर्दर ऑन 12th May 1946 इन बेलगाम एन इंपॉर्टेंट रेजोल्यूशन रिगार्डिंग संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र वॉज पास्ट। नाउ व्हाट दिस संयुक्त महाराष्ट्र परिषद डिड, दे कॉल्ड अ मीटिंग एट मुंबई वेयर शंकर राव देव वॉज द प्रेसिडेंट। ही पास्ड अ रेजोल्यूशन दैट ऑल द मराठी स्पीकिंग रीजन शुड बी इंक्लूडेड इन वन स्टेट। दिस शुड नॉट ओनली इंक्लूड मराठी स्पीकिंग रीजन ऑफ मुंबई, central provinces as well as Marathwada and Gomantak. Now in order to bring success to this, a commission was set up called Dar Commission on 17th June 1947. Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the president of the Constituent Assembly, established Dar Commission under the Justice of S.K. Dar for forming linguistic provinces. On 10th December 1948, the report of Dar Commission was published, but the issue remained unsolved. Since issue remained unsolved, there was JVP committee. It included Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhai Patel and the other members. It was known by their initial. They were known as JVP committee. the report suggested, the committee has given a report and the report suggested the Congress accept the concept of linguistic state in principle, but time was not proper for it. Severe response was seen throughout Maharashtra against this report. During that time, Senapati Bapat organized rallies for awakening of the people. Acharya Atre got passed the proposal of Samyukta Maharashtra with Mumbai in Mumbai Municipal Corporation. It got passed by 50 against 35 votes. Due to it, the desire of Mumbai should be included in Maharashtra was proven. Now, my dear students, we could see the Commission of Reconstruction of the State. This Commission of Reconstruction of the State was appointed on 29th December 1953 under the chairmanship of Justice Fazal Ali. This commission presented their proposal on 10th October 1955. This proposal advocated for creating bilingual Mumbai state. My dear students, further we will see Marathi speaking people all over region should resolve to make one state for the purpose of signing the Nagpur Pact in 1953. According to the pact, Samyukta Maharashtra was formed, including Western Maharashtra, Vidarbha, with Marathwada. In 1956, as per the amendment of the Constitution, Article 371 was included in it. According to the Nagpur Pact, assurance was given regarding equitable financial provisions for the development of the work, ample finance for the technical, vocational, educational provision of the state, government service in particular region in accordance with the population. Assembly sessions once in a year should be held in Nagpur. The struggle of the Marathi people or Marathi speaking people for the formation of Maharashtra with Mumbai had begun. Huge meeting held at Kamgar Maidan in Mumbai. At that time, Shankar Dev said, "We will oppose separation of Mumbai from Maharashtra up to the last breath." The emotions and the demands of the people took the form of public agitation. Women spontaneously started participating in it. Sumita Bai Gore, Durga Bhagwat, Tara Reddy, Charushile Gupte, Kamalatai More, Sultana Johari, many such women took part in the agitation. On 7th November 1955, there was meeting of the laborers, various laborers organization, communist, Praja, Socialist Peasants, Workers' Party, Janasangha, all this political party participated in it. Comrade Shimrat Amrut Dange presided over it. Here, S.M. Joshi proposed a resolution of Samyukta Maharashtra with Mumbai and Vidarbha should be created. Now, my dear students, further we will see the beginning of actual conflict. Discontent among the Marathi speaking people was growing. A grand march was led by Senapati Bapat, taken to Vidhan Sabha. Morarji Desai was the chief minister at that time. The government declared a ban. The police started lorry charge, used tear gas. On that evening, open meeting was conducted in Kamgar Maidan with the mob around 50,000. Comrade Dange guided this people to accelerate the struggle for Samyukta Maharashtra movement. On 21st November 1955, decision of one-day token strike was taken. Students, Further, we will see the issue of the demand of the Marathi speaking people started becoming complicated. Discontent spread throughout the state. On 6th February 1956, a meeting was conducted under the chairmanship of Keshav Rao at Tilak Smarak Mandir in Pune. The Samiti declared its executive council, Comrade Shripad Amrudange, as the president. Vice President and S.M. Joshi as General Secretary, P.K. Atre, Madhu Dandavate, Prabandhakar, Keshav Thakre, Y.K. Soni played an important role in establishing the Samiti. At the same time, Senapati Bapat, Krantisena Nana Patil, Ahilyabai contributed immensely to Samyukt Maharashtra movement. They spread the movement to rural parts of Maharashtra. When it was clear that Mumbai will not be included in Maharashtra at the time, there aroused a huge public agitation. In this movement, 106 people became martyred in firing opened by the state government. In memory of 106 sons of Maharashtra who became martyr for the formation of Samyukt Maharashtra, the Hutatma Samarak was erected in Mumbai near Flora Fountain. On 1st November 1946, bilingual Mumbai state came into existence. Later in 1957, Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabha, Mumbai Municipal Corporation election was held. Samyukt Maharashtra Samiti got grand success. This results made clear that the voters were against bilingual state and in favor of Samyukt Maharashtra. The unveiling of statues of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj mounted on a horse on Pratapgarh was done on the hand of Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru on 30th November 1957. At that time, Samyukt Maharashtra Samiti decided to make a huge demonstration under leadership of Bhai Madhavrao Bagal. Leader like S.M. Joshi, N.G. Gore, Jyotirao Thilak, P.K. Atre, Udhavrao Patil was present. Severe demonstration was made Pasarani Ghat and Polarpur. The Samiti succeeded in making Pandit Nehru aware of the condition as well as the sentiments of the Marathi speaking people. The central government favored in making Maharashtra due to agitation due to led by Samyukta Maharashtra Samiti. At this time, Mrs. Indira Gandhi was the president of the Congress who supported the Samyukta Maharashtra movement. The central government consented the two linguistic states, Maharashtra and Gujarat, in April 1960. Parliament passed the Mumbai Reorganization Act. According to this act, Maharashtra state was formed on 1st May 1960. At the dawn of 1st May 1960, in the special ceremony at Raj Bhavan, on the occasion of Labour Day, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehruji announced the formation of the Maharashtra state and Yashwantrao Chavan accepted the responsibility of the first Chief Minister of Maharashtra. Thus, my dear students, I would like to conclude this lesson. This is how our Maharashtra state was formed. And I am proud to say, Maharashtra state is not only a state which is only there for Marathi speaking people, but Maharashtra is a state who has welcomed all the people right from north to south, from east to west, and we can see Mumbai as a city which is cosmopolitan. And this is how Maharashtra state is formed. Students, if you like this video, please do like it. If you have not subscribed it, please subscribe it and also share this video with others. Thank you, and I wish you all the best for your examination.